The views and opinions expressed on Unlock Your Wealth Radio are those of the host, guests, and callers only, and are not necessarily the views of Unlock Your Wealth Radio, Heather Wagenhals, or Success Publishing International.
Worried about retirement? Want to travel the world or just be around to watch your kids grow up, but you can't because you're drowning in debt? Now you can! With Heather Wagenhals and the Keys to Riches, powered by Unlock Your Wealth Radio. Heather will show you how to stop chasing your wallet, eliminate debt, lose financial stress, and live the life of your dreams. If you truly ever wanted to have more, do more, be and give back more, now's your chance. Listen weekly to hear what others are doing to manage their money better with these proven strategies for building wealth with the Keys to Riches financial philosophy. Now, here's your host, Heather Wagenhals.
And you're on.
Woo! The Keys to Riches, powered by Unlock Your Wealth Radio, is sponsored in part by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download at heathersfreeaudiobook.com and click on the link to over 150,000 titles to choose from for your iPhone, Android, Kindle, or MP3 player. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for stopping by. We are so glad to have you. I'm Heather Wagenhals, flanked by my producer extraordinaire, Michael Terry.
How do you like that new theme song?
I love it!
Yeah.
We sound professional now.
It was fun. We've always sounded fairly professional, but that is some icing on the cake.
It is definitely over the top icing on the cake. And it's that good, like, whipped cream icing, yeah. Not that buttercream kind of like you feel like you just ate the side of a hunk of.
It's not generic radio music.
No.
It's something a little deeper.
We're top notch here. And because we're top notch, we're going to help you get your money mind right on today's show with the Keys to Riches financial philosophy. So first off, what is our key today?
Knowledge is power. Not knowing is powerful.
Ding, 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 ding. Yay. We got that one out of you without too much coaxing.
It's taken me, what, 3 or 4 years?
I don't know. We started this, what, 30 years ago, but... Now, it's good that it's caught on now. I'm glad. Glad it's finally sunk in. So, so we are going to learn about our knowledge checklist, because that's what's so important is people don't have a foundation of financial money management to springboard from. So, last week, you remember, we started figuring out where we want to go with our dreams with deadlines, and we're going to show you how that fits into today's overall big picture of things. So we're going to talk about our three questions and five areas of concern on today's show. Now, our moolah word of the day, how about some free markets and some free enterprise? Would you like that?
Sure.
Yeah.
We love that.
We're going to define that today because we don't have that. I know people like to be deluded into thinking that's
right.
What we have, but
right.
It's not. And we're going to talk about that on today's show. Also, our money drama for today is?
Being organized, preparing, preparing for stuff.
Well, I'll lead it off this way.
This is why you do the show and not me.
Perhaps that's why you're sidekick. Well, you live up to your title.
Yeah.
You do provide the comic relief. You are quite the maestro of the sound effects and make sure that we sound top notch.
Yeah.
So you're doing good though.
Yeah.
You're doing good. So that's close. So we need to think in terms of what my old investment banker used to say to me. And he said, it's not that people plan to fail. They just fail to plan. And so we're going to talk about how the vicious circle, if you will, of not having any plan in place. And because we're fearful sometimes of doing the wrong thing, so we get hung up in analysis paralysis. I've used that term before. And not knowing what plan to do. And so we're going to talk about how we need to have some financial foundation, and that's what we lead into with these keys today, because that's what's so critical about our ability to succeed at money management is to have something to springboard from. It may not be 100% working for you, but as long as you understand what you need to know, the gaps in knowledge you can go out and get or delegate. And that's the critical point of today's key. But first, let's address our moolah word of the day, shall we? So free enterprise is business governed by the laws of supply and demand, not restrained by government interference, regulation, or subsidy. It is also called a free market. And for those of you who have been regular listeners of the Unlock Your Wealth radio website and radio program, you know that I'm a big proponent of free markets because the markets will take care of themselves, because there's a difference between voting for a person in a governmental establishment to protect you and voting with your dollar, because the market, when it's allowed to determine its own destiny, pays attention to when you vote with your dollars. And if you stop voting with your dollars by stopping shopping somewhere or stopping buying a particular item, the market gets it and they will make moves accordingly. So that's why it's critical to have as limited a government interference in our marketplace as possible. Now, at one point in this country, and without engaging in a huge political discussion, there were some changes that needed to occur in the marketplace that government regulation helped. But some of that stuff has long since worn out its welcome and it's not needed anymore. And I would like to say unions, but like I said, that's a political discussion, not necessarily a financial one for today. But that's our word of the day is, or moolah word of the day, I should say, free enterprise. So let's talk about the keys to riches. Shallery, are you ready to move on?
I'm ready. I was going to say, I was going to ask if the union situation is getting stronger on the union side or stronger on the non-union side as time moves on.
Well, what's interesting is people are starting to not be led by sheep, the union members. What's nice is, so they're starting to ask questions and they want to be able to, you know, I mean, do you remember that whole anonymous voting thing that came up a while ago? You know, so they don't want to be singled out for voting against what everybody else is supposed to be voting for because it's not in their best interest, but they're afraid. But, you know, they get stuck in these states that are union states that this union that's supposed to be their voice, that, and they don't agree with what the union is doing, but, you know, their job is predicated on them becoming a union member. It's very frustrating for them.
Yeah.
So it's a catch-22, and it's not something that we'll solve on this show. So if you are in a position that you're stuck in a union and are fearful of voting, perhaps you might want to continue or consider employment in another area that is a right to work state. That's how you solve that, is you leave the union.
Right.
You know, and again, if more people made a mass exodus out of the union and sought employment elsewhere, because, you know, in some of these union states, they're not the only states that manufacture or produce whatever it is. You know, there are other states around the country that are now right to work states that have great manufacturing opportunities. And, you know, I can think of one particular industry, and I don't want to single them out. But
how many right-to-work states are there? Do you know?
Not off the top of my head.
Yeah. Texas, I know, is one. Is Arizona?
Yes.
Arizona.
We have unions, but we're still right-to-work. Yeah. I mean, there's, the, you know, there's a couple different ones, but they don't hold a whole lot of weight.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, you can find a place that can meet your needs if it's really important to you. To be free and not controlled and have your life controlled or dictated, or your job specifically controlled or dictated by other people, then that would be to your benefit. But let's switch gears and talk about today's key in the Keys to Riches financial philosophy, shall we? So the Keys to Riches is a financial philosophy that teaches you how to think like the rich and be in control of your own money. It also gives you specific techniques to create or fix your credit, eliminate debt, save and invest, all while transforming your current financial habits into healthy money management skills. And today's key is knowledge is power, not knowing is powerful. And it's our fourth key. And it's a critical key because what we're going to do is we're going to talk about the knowledge checklist that we need to have in order to function financially and get on that path to financial freedom. So there's three extremely important questions you need to ask yourself when it comes to money management, successful money management. That is, where am I? The second one is, where am I going? And the third one is, what's the difference? And what you'll see once we get to our break the budget key and we actually figure out how to create a healthy savings and spending plan, we'll figure out where that what's the difference comes into play. Because that happens on two levels. So let's address the first question first. So where am I? This we started already in take action, make assessment. We need to have an accurate financial snapshot of where we are so we know when we set up last week's key, which was dreams with deadlines, that answers our second question is where am I going? We'll have a way to measure for that third question, what's the difference? Am I getting closer to or further away from my financial goals? Mm-hmm. Because what we have to remember is when we achieve our financial goals, every other personal, spiritual, professional, familial goal can fall into place. And why is that? Because in order to fulfill some of our hopes, dreams, and desires, it takes money to do that. And the more we say, oh, money's not important to me, the bigger the problems you usually have with money. Because our problems with money don't have to do with money itself, but it has to do with our attitudes and behaviors in all areas of our life mm-hmm. that affect our money. And so that's why we have to get a good grip on things. So for those of you who are just joining us for the first time, welcome to the Keys to Riches radio program powered by Unlock Your Wealth Radio. Now, in our first key, we had to accept and affirm that we needed to get going on our money management. That what we're doing isn't working or we don't know what to do and we need to get started on something. And then our second key, we said we needed to take action to make assessments. So now we're gathering the information to accurately identify where it is that we are financially. And then last week, we decided to figure out where it is we want to go. So we have a milestone to achieve. And so this key is going to address those three questions. And we also have to address five areas of concern. And this is where our knowledge checklist comes in handy. And it's because we need to know what we should be paying attention to when it comes to our finances. Because if we don't know, that's where we're going to have big problems. That's where we can be taken for fraud or scammed. That's where we can make mistakes. We can trust the wrong people, or we don't have the right people in place to protect ourselves. And so that's why we have to address these five areas of concern in addition to answering these three questions. So the way we do that is we first have to learn what they are. So let's run through those five areas of concern. So our first area of concern is income and expenses, okay? We need to know what's going in and what's going out, okay? And the only way to do that is to create a healthy savings and spending plan. And so we've started addressing this particular area of concern in our second key by taking action and making assessment. So we're in the process of that because if you listen to that show, you know that it's not sit down and just look at my bank accounts and come up with a balance sheet. A balance sheet is part of it, but we're doing a deeper analysis, if you recall from that show, and we're going to look at the when things happen so we can get behind the behavior drivers when we make mistakes with our money. Because it's not about how much, okay? Because that's all relative. So you're going to make mistakes relative to your income level. You're not going to be making the same mistakes as a professional athlete, but the mistake that you make is the same, just the dollar amount is different. Mm-hmm. And that's what I've learned from all of my coaching of celebrities, professional athletes, and musicians is that just the numbers change, but the mistakes are the same. The same things happen when certain behaviors are driving financial decisions. So we're going to take care of that key. Then our second key that we have to pay attention to is our protections area of concern. And the reason why we have this area of concern is we need to have certain protections in place that protect us while we are building our wealth. And so this is insuring for our financial success with insurances. And there's a variety that we need to have as individuals. And people think insurance is a waste of money. Or I can't afford health insurance, but I'm making payments on my big screen TV. So the idea behind insurance, and I'm not going to belabor that point because that's a money drama we'll talk about later on. But what we have to think about is insurance isn't a waste of money. Insurance is renting millionaire status before we get there. We pay because we are not millionaires yet. and we're just embarking on the path to becoming financially free, we don't have necessarily those deep pockets. You might be, you're like, wait a minute, this is week four, Heather. I haven't even started saving my emergency fund. What are you talking about? So you might not even have an emergency fund in place, not even be able to do like a $50,000 heart, you know, bypass or something like that, you know? So you're like, I can't afford that. But so that's why we have insurances, because it allows us to rent those deep pockets for a fraction of the money. So for a couple of $100 a month, you can have access to $50,000 should you need your heart valve repaired, right? Mm-hmm. So that makes sense. But there's different types of insurance. So there's not only health insurance, there's life insurance. If you have an insurable interest, if your income has dependence upon it, if you're financially responsible for other people or other things, you need to have life insurance in place in case of your accidental demise. Then there's long-term care insurance. There's key man insurance. If you're in a business and you're an entrepreneur, but you're not the one with the secret sauce, maybe you're the guy that runs the business, but your business partner is the brains behind the operation. He's the inventor, whatever, the widget that's made you guys wildly successful. You need to have key man insurance, because if he goes away, likely the business will, because that's not your area of expertise. So these are other critical things that need to be in place. You have car insurance in case somebody crashes into you or something like that. So insurances are extremely important. And that's why we have this whole area of concern called protections, because depending upon where you are in life and where you're going and what your goals are, your insurances need to go with you. And you need to rent insurance until you can be self-insured. And that's why this is such an important level, because sometimes we buy insurance that we don't need. And so that's why it's critical that we learn about the insurances and stuff. And we have an insurance checklist at our website. If you just visit keystoriches.com, you can download that. And then in addition to that, we also have our asset accumulation, which is the beginning of our savings plan. So in this asset accumulation stage, you're going to start creating that emergency fund. This is your tiered savings. And you're going to start an emergency fund, a quality of life savings, and your retirement savings. Wow. Okay? But we have to remember that there's a difference between the words of saving and investing. So this is the asset accumulation phase. This is how we start to get on that path. This is also maybe if we buy a home too, because that's an asset we've accumulated. But we want investments to be able to grow, and we want them to be able to create their own cash flow too. So that's where our next layer of concern is. And that fourth layer of concern is asset multiplication. And this is where we take our savings and we leverage those savings by investing them and getting our dollars working as hard as we are. And the final layer of concern that we need to pay attention to in our five areas of concern is asset preservation. Because once we've created this beautiful familial empire for ourselves and our family, this is about, you know, reducing tax liability and preserving your legacy and making sure that what you've done and what you've built goes to the people that you want it to go to and not to the people that you don't. So you have to be active about that, because if you don't make those decisions, and if you've been listening to this season on Unlock Your Wealth Radio, we've had a number of estate planners call and become a part of the show and talk about the importance of you making those decisions with a qualified estate planning professional versus some judge that's never met you at a court that has nothing to do with anything that you've ever done or accomplished in your lifetime. And he has no idea whose siblings are estranged or who's really the good kid. They don't know that, and they're going to make an equitable division, and it might not be in line with what you want. So for this week's key statement, key affirmation, and key action item, you need to visit keystoriches.com for all of our downloads. You are listening to The Keys to Riches, powered by Unlock Your Wealth Radio. This segment of today's show is sponsored in part by KeepMyID.org, the only service that actually prevents identity theft. All others are just monitoring services. Put your credit on lockdown with their special offer for Keys to Riches. Radio listeners, visit keystoriches.com/KeepMyID to enroll and protect your financial future right now. So this week's money drama, as we talked about it, was failing to plan. And we need to think in terms of how many times have you said, well, when I get the next paycheck, I'll start saving. That was always what I heard from my mother. You know, she used to preach about starting mutual funds and how everybody can become a millionaire with just, you know, a dollar a day. But she never did it. She never did it, you know. Apparently, she went through the training to be a financial advisor at American Express Financial Advisors. But, you know, because I remember that we never had babysitters growing up. We were like full-on latchkey at really early ages. Probably, if it happened in this day and age, my mom would have gotten arrested for child endangerment or something, you know, leaving an 8 and 6-year-old home alone. But, you know, I remember at night, we went to my brother's godparents' house. And, you know, we spent, you know, like a couple of weeks there. And I guess that's when she was going through a training. But I don't know why it never worked out. I don't know what happened, you know, because my mom's a great salesperson. So I don't know how she goofed that up. Mm. You know, if she would have stuck with it, it could have totally changed her life. But for the better, you know, she would have had a nice professional job and something to fall back on and everything. But, you know, she always preached that stuff, but she never did it herself. And then, you know, she never had money for anything, you know, whenever we needed stuff. And so we would always ask, well, you know, you keep talking about saving money. Well, next paycheck, I will. Next paycheck, I will, you know? And it's just like, well, why not this paycheck? I mean, can we even save a dollar or $2 or something?
Yeah.
You know? And it just never happened. And so it's not like she was planning to fail, but she didn't have an effective course of action. And she had the education, but she's a very present moment kind of person, and she always lived that way. And so, I mean, still today, you know, it's all about the bargains. And it doesn't make any sense. And I think that we get hung up in this cycle. So many people, because of their timidity, because they're afraid, oh, I don't know enough. Or, you know, I heard people lose money in investments. Well, they also make money too. And people only lose money when they don't study and do enough research to make a decision to go forward. And we have to remember that risk is commensurate to reward. So if you don't like a lot of risk, you can find investments that have very little risk. But what do we know now? We're like at a zero savings rate. So if you put your money in the bank right now, you're losing money because the rate of inflation is higher than the rate of savings. So your money would be better served under a mattress. I mean, what would happen if interest rates went negative? You know, and like, I can't even believe that that was actually bantered about. The problem isn't the supply of money. The problem is that we've had low rates for so long and people have taken advantage of them, and they've allowed that to become the new norm instead of understanding the value of what has happened and taking advantage of it. I mean, mortgages should be about 8 to 9%. That's normal. That's where they should be.
Yeah.
I mean, it's ridiculous that this has gone on so long, and it's clearly that people over the last, you know, 7 years do not understand monetary policy, you know, in an effective way, you know, and we've really goofed up this economy. But, you know, with easy access to money and interest rates, like I said, not paying out, you know, we always think, well, I'll start saving later, you know, or we hear about the bounce in the stock market and then we get hesitant.
Yeah.
And I mean, I remember just, you know, what was it, a month or so ago, you mentioned something about the bounce, and I said, sink every extra penny you can at the beginning of the market and bam, buy all you can at the open, because it's going to go back up. It always goes back up.
Yeah.
You know, so that's the beauty. And that's what we know about the markets, is that they always go back up. So it depends on the investment vehicle. For those of you who have been regular listeners of the Unlock Your Wealth radio show, I've always been a big proponent of real estate because it's a physical asset. You can go out and touch it and feel it. You know that it's there. You can visit it. And regardless of whether the economy is doing well or not so well, everybody needs a place to live.
Yeah.
We all need a place to live. And wouldn't it be great if somebody else could build your wealth that you don't have to go out and get 30 extra jobs? I mean, it makes a whole lot of sense. Mm-hmm. So the key is that we have to have a foundation. And so this is the perfect plan, these three questions and five areas of concern to complete the assessment that we're starting in key two, to truly know where you are financially. So let's just review those real quick again. So that is, where am I? So that's going to be our balance sheet. And then we're also going to do our behavior analysis with that. And then we've got, where am I going? And that's going to be our goals worksheet that we created So our goal achievement strategy. And then finally, we're going to do our what's the difference. And we're going to get to that later in the keys because it's not relevant to what we're doing now. But that what's the difference is two things. So it's also going to be another balance sheet checkup, a quarterly checkup to see where we are. But each and every month, we're going to do a cash flow statement. What's the difference? How much is coming in and how much is going out? And what we're going to learn is in order to appropriately address our tiered savings plan, we're going to make sure that every month our cash flow zeros out. And that's because we're going to make savings a payment like a bill, like our credit card. We're going to make our savings and investments bill payments. So we should actually have a zero cash flow, not positive. And that's the goal. And that's different than most people say, well, you want to spend less than you make. And that's true. But we don't necessarily want a positive cash flow because then we can be frivoling that away also. So we want to make sure that we've got it tucked away. And that's why we want to take and do it that way and create it as a build. And that's the way that I like to set up our financial savings and spending plans when we get to the break the budget key. And so we'll talk about that more on that key. So that's it for this week's show. Visit keystoriches.com for the key statement, key affirmation, and key action item for this week. And for more in-depth interviews with money experts, strategies, and members-only tools to fix your credit, get out of debt, and have more money and happiness, do what other savvy listeners have and visit our sister site at unlockyourwealthradio.com where you go to get your money mind right so your wealth and happiness will follow. If you haven't already, be sure and sign up for our complimentary Introduction to the Keys to Riches video series. Join other listeners just like you and get your money mind right in 12 weeks with the Keys to Riches Financial Wellness Series. For the Keys to Riches powered by Unlock Your Wealth Radio and the Maestro of Moolah, Michael Terry, I'm Heather Wagenhals. Now go out and unlock your wealth today.
UnlockYourWealthRadio.com is produced by Heather Wagenhals and the Unlock Your Wealth Foundation. UnlockYourWealthRadio.com and its affiliates are copyrighted 2015 with all rights reserved. For more information on the Keys to Riches Financial Wellness Series, please visit our website at www.unlockyourwealth.com.